What up, guys? It's Glenn here with Street Truck Channel. So I know it's been a few weeks since I've brought anything to the channel. I finally got through my wedding, the hell week that went along before the wedding, the week after the wedding with my honeymoon and things like that. And then after coming back from my honeymoon and going back to work, I took a week off from doing any type of filming then. So, with that being said, I'm back on the channel. I've got footage from a testing tune that I'm going to upload as well. But I just want to go ahead. I have been playing around with the Blazer. And I've also done a few things to my Papa's truck that I know I introduced to the channel, but have yet to really bring any kind of content for that truck. It's just been in the background of some videos and things like that. So what I want to do is just kind of do a quick walk around and talk about a few things I've been working on, and just get some stuff uploaded for you guys that do follow the channel and enjoy some of the stuff that we do goofing off and playing with our vehicles. So with that being said, let's take a stroll in here to the shop. I guess I'll start with the Blazer here. So I have played with it a little bit, not much though. I'm waiting on my Holley Terminator X. Holley is been on the back burner, I guess. They've been taking a little bit of time to get some of their stuff in, a lot longer than I was expecting. But as you can see, the Blazer sat for over a month without really much been going on. But I did pull the radiator support, and I recessed the radiator. It should give me a little over 2 more inches of clearance for my up and forward headers. So that was a plus. I was kind of hoping I wouldn't have to do that. Was shooting for running the aluminum radiator support that a guy on Facebook sells. But not really able to go that route just yet. Maybe this coming up winter. So I just went ahead and for nothing, little nothing, a couple cut off wheels, and I just cut and recessed the radiator into the core support, which give me enough room to hopefully be able to get my exhaust and everything to flow down and go out the lower valence, kind of like what I'm planning to do. So that helped out. I'm still hopefully planning to do the Motion Raceworks booster delete. That's also something I'm looking forward to doing. So and that'll be later on down the road. I did get both of my fans mounted. They're mounted to the radiator. Amazon, $25 a piece. We'll see how long they last. There was a gentleman on Facebook I've spoken to multiple different times who wanted me to kind of explain how I mounted my parachute mount. So with the Blazers, there is a cross member that runs across the rear on this side of the fuel tank that is centrally mounted in the frame rails. So what I done is I got my measurement to that cross member, and I pulled the sliding outer piece out to where I was happy with it. I marked it. Then that told me where I needed to drill my my support or my bolt hole, so I could put my pin in to make it a quick release. I could pull this mount just by pulling the pin and move it out of the way if I need to for any kind of reason. It's easily removable. So all I did was I just welded it straight to that cross member, and I've got some angled supports that kick off both sides that also weld to that cross member just to make it extra sturdy. Because I just welding it straight to it with no type of gusset or anything, I wouldn't imagine it'd last very long. But this blazer won't be going that fast anytime soon. So it was one of those things where I went ahead while I had the opportunity and I was messing with it and went ahead and put it on there because to me it's a little more of a safety feature than the blazer's going so fast through the traps. I have to have one. I would much rather have it on there in case I get a little out of shape and I feel like I can hit the chute and maybe straighten the blazer back up. It just kind of make me feel a little more comfortable knowing I've got it there. But outside of that, I mean, I haven't really done much to the blazer. I picked me up a seat for the blazer. My Turbo 400, I finally got finished getting the bell housing on it. I found the slip yoke for this long tail shaft Turbo 400. Pretty sure the long tail shaft 400s come out of the big body cars and things like that. Not 100% sure because I don't know a whole lot about these transmissions, but I did find the yoke. So it's sitting there, it's ready to go. And my converter come in from PTC. So I'm pretty excited about that. All I got to do really now that the converter's here, is I can get everything in the blazer bolted up. And then I can get my cross member put back underneath there and modify it to the point where I can see where the new mounting point for the Turbo 400 is going to be. I've seen several other guys upload videos on YouTube that kind of give a good idea of what I got to do to get it mounted. So hopefully it's not that big of a trouble to really reuse the cross member, because I don't really plan on spending the money to order an aftermarket one right now. I'm more interested in getting it put together and getting it running and make sure and I don't have to go back and redo a bunch of stuff. So that's kind of where the blazer's at right now. Not a whole lot. That's why I haven't really done a big update for the blazer to the channel yet. But what I do want to do is I want to just kind of maybe introduce my papa's truck a little bit better for you guys. The truck sat for several years before I got it. So I have been playing with it some while I wait on my Holley Terminator X. That's kind of got me at a little bit of a stopping point on the blazer besides getting the transmission in. So I finally put a little effort in my papa's truck to get it more road worthy and be able to cruise it around town and kind of enjoy it. So I'm gonna pull it out of the shop real quick, and that way I can kind of do a walk around of it. It is a 88 model, or 88 late 88, 89. And this truck is a TBI truck. So it has the, I guess what a lot of people call the junk for these trucks. Nobody that I've ever talked to likes the TBI. So I've got some things going to kind of fix that. I'm going to try to, this truck is a 700R truck. and I've got the option with the transmission that's in it, I can get rid of the TBI, hopefully, from what I've been told. And I can put an intake and carburetor on this truck and should be able to let it breathe, open it up a little bit better, and it should run quite a bit better than the little TBI will allow it to. So a lot of the stuff that's been done to this truck, my grandfather did several years ago. The truck's been painted a little different shade of gold pewter than what it was originally. It's a gold color off of a Buick car around the same year that he picked when he had the truck completely repainted. And so the front bumper and stuff, I got it from Drew. It come off of the gray truck back when it was still fenders and steel hood and steel bumper, all that good stuff. And when he made the decision to go fiberglass and pull all the parts off, I was fortunate enough that he let me get some of the parts and things off of that truck, which at the time worked out real well as far as kind of cleaning up and updating some of the stuff on my papa's truck. I was able to purchase the Raystars from him. Just recently went and picked up these drag radials. Wasn't exactly what I was looking for, but the 255 60 15s that was on the Raystars, the street tires, was just way too small. The truck looked a little depressing to me, so I found a good deal on these 315 60 15s, and I drove and picked them up and put them on there, and to be honest with you, I really didn't think they was going to fit. But after getting them on the truck, I love them. I think they turned out real good. I actually wish the truck was about an inch or so lower in the rear and kind of sat down on them just a little bit more. And I think it would help with the look of them being a little big. But everybody has their own opinion. I like them. So at the end of the day, I guess that's really all that matters. But I was able to finally get an oil pan or a roll pan put on the truck. So kind of excited about that. I'm going to eventually, when I make my mind up what I'm going to do, I'm going to color match it to the truck. But I mean, that's pretty much it on this truck. My papa did put seats and an old console out of the later year truck. This is actually a console out of an extended cab, and I'm pretty sure these are the same seats that come out of the tan or come out of the extended cab, just like my 96 sitting over there. He done all that himself several years ago. They're a little thick. They, I guess, being that they're from an extended cab, they build the seats a little differently. I'm not sure, but they really are. They're a little too thick built for the standard cab style trucks. But outside of that, I mean, it's a pretty cool old truck. I'm trying to get it to where I can enjoy it with my sons and things like that, and make it a really cool cruiser. Here's the valance that he had on it. I've hit it with several cans of paint stripper to get all the years of old paint off of it, and I'm gonna try and clean it up and eventually get it put back on the truck, because I think it's a pretty cool addition. Plus, it adds more to the truck to me to have the same valance put back on it that my papa originally put on the truck. It was just in really poor condition, so that's why I pulled it off. But here's the intake. I picked up a guy I work with, give me this intake. So you can't beat free. I'll take it all day long. And pick these aluminum valve covers up for cheap, just to kind of add a little bit. Nothing crazy. And I also managed to get this Holley carburetor that I'm gonna go through. Give it to me, so I'm gonna go through it, get it freshened up, and hopefully that'll be another video I can upload to the channel for you guys. Getting rid of and ditching the TBI setup and putting an intake carburetor and cleaning the motor up on this older truck, and I'm hoping by doing so it'll run a heck of a lot better. And but as of right now, guys, really that's all. I mean, I just wanted to get back on here and let you know I hadn't forgot about none of you guys. And if you haven't already, I know I'm gonna upload this to the Facebook Street Truck Channel page, and I just finally got the Street Truck Channel Instagram finished. Going to be uploading on there as well. So if you haven't subscribed or liked to any of them, or on the YouTube channel, if you're on Facebook Street Truck Channel, if you're part of the Facebook family and you haven't subscribed or liked the actual YouTube channel, do so. I just took a small break because of my wedding and honeymoon and things like that. But with that being said, guys, I hope you enjoy some of the stuff I've been putting out, and I really appreciate you guys following the channel. Stay tuned. There is test and tune footage of the gray truck with Bo Cephas that's coming. Thank you, guys.